in the beginning years, lot of people were able to get a premium. That premium will get knocked out. They won't be able to get that special price. So people will have to create efficiency in the sector to sustain itself. Now, the price point will be very much lower going forward, and efficiency will be the key if you want to remain in the real estate market. From the access book point of view, it was a natural extension for us because we have, in access engineering, we have one of the leading civil companies in the country. Then in access international, access lifestyle and this and that, from the lift to tiles to bathroom fittings, we have it all within the group. So we can, as a result, transfer that price advantage. And I believe in the real estate sector, the most important factor is location, location, location. I think that is universal and everybody knows that this fact. So because we are in infrastructure development, we know where the roads are coming, we know where the water supply projects are going to come in the future, and where the rail projects or the light rail, all that. So we try to get ahead of, take the first early move advantage and build our development projects around those factors. For example, we are very well aware of Port City project. So with the Port City developer, China Harbour, we are building around over 1,000 apartments, 2-3 kilometers away from the Port City, because for any future developer or investor in Port City, they'll need accommodation. So I think, contrary to alarm and people being worried about a bubble and all, I think it is a false alarm, you know. But of course, the developer has to be a reliable and well-structured developer. If a developer is trying to develop only on advances or something, then that type of developer will get into problems sooner or later. But if you have right equity debt proportions and if you are a reliable developer, I think you can stay in the market for a long, long time.
I think you kind of stopped on a good point there about the liquidity of the developer, and what we've seen in the last few years is lots of developments coming up, as in launching, by different players in the market. But we've seen most of them kind of not kind of go ahead, or they've slowed down, they got delayed. And what people are saying is there's bound to be lots of apartment units coming up in future, and there will be oversupply in the market. And just, do you believe in the same thing?
No, I don't think there will be oversupply. There will be a loss of confidence going to haphazard development, not conforming to the UDA and local government and other approvals, and also going to liquidity issues of the developer. For example, you know, it's, if you build 20 houses, you build one house, you can wait without building the 19. You start an apartment complex of 250 around apartments, you have to finish everything to sell even one. So liquidity becomes a very, very critical issue, and the ability to sustain the development irrespective of your sales. For example, the last 1 year, the overall apartment market sales have come down a little, you know, into variety of reasons, including the rupee and the dollar and all that, you know. And also the banks being very skeptical about the real estate sector. But the good developers will remain, like everything else. Now, you know, you can remember Mr. Premadasa, when he was president, started 200 government factories. Everybody got on the bandwagon. But 25, 30, 40 years ago, few companies have survived and they've done very well. Others, it's the same in any sector, you know. The good companies, the efficient companies, the professional companies will remain. And some, that is part of life.
And another kind of policy change that might affect the kind of apartments being sold is the newly introduced VAT, which is supposed to come in April. What are your thoughts? Do you think it will happen? And what, if it does happen, what are the effects that the market will feel when it comes into effect?
I think the market should be able to absorb it. Actually, although the VAT is 15%, the real impact is about 8% or little more than that. Because when they charge VAT, all our input VAT can be claimed. So now we cannot claim the input VAT. So it becomes a cost to us, to the developer. So when you have VAT on the selling price, so it's not fair to transfer the full 15% to the buyer. And also, if the buyer is a VAT paying organization, then it becomes much cheaper for them. You know, because they have that much advantage, because they can claim it as an input VAT, you know. And also, we have to understand some of the apartment developments are with tax holidays and all. So they have to pay some tax to as a stakeholder in the country. And there will be less unfair practices also when VAT is charged, you know. Because when VAT is not charged, some companies try to avoid the input VAT. So it distorts the market. So I think that should not be a problem. But what is important, that it must be implemented in a fair manner in the interim. Because now, for example, from day one, if you knew you were having VAT, that's fine. But if you have purchased something and then the developer has to go and tell them, now our price is going up, then it's, I don't think, very fair or very ethical or professional. It's not our fault, but then that is the message we are trying to give to the government, that, you know, for a new project it's fine, but for the projects that are in the pipeline, they must look at it and give a fair and equitable solution.
And another factor that's kind of affected the market heavily is the affordability. As we know, most people cannot afford the luxury end of the market. There's a big demand for apartments below, let's say, 30 million. Where do you think it's heading? Can we see more demand for the plus 30 million market, or do you think the developer should focus on the more affordable properties going forward?
It all depends on the general development of the country's infrastructure. I yet believe if you can't get a good school, a good hospital, and a good social club, and your social activities and your family activities within 5 to 10 kilometers, people will sooner or later opt for the apartment living. Because, you know, now yesterday I went to Morotu, it took me 1.5 hours. So the younger generation is not going to accept that, you know. So unless it all depends on the speed of our infrastructure development and the quality of life improvement by living in Colombo or living in an apartment. So I think on the short term, definitely the apartments, because you can't build a house now today. If you buy 10 purchase anywhere in Colombo, it will be 50 million. 10 purchase, you know, anywhere in Colombo. Not Colombo 7, even Colombo 5 or 6 or any of the Colombo addresses, or even around Rajagiriya, that area. Now the land price is about 4 million a purchase. So that means you're talking about two apartments, you know.
Yeah.
So it with the land prices going up, you have to compare the apartment price.
Okay, the other question is, if you take the foreign involvement to the property market, expats and pure foreigners, it's around 5 to 10%. How do you think the foreign participation of foreign buyers and investors can be improved, and will that, you know, affect the market as a whole, you know, once we get the foreigners?
Yeah, the main factor where when you look at the foreigners, there are two things in my mind. One is the stability of the rupee, because foreigners are bringing foreign exchange. So if the rupee, they are not confident, will remain at a acceptable level, they will not want to buy a rupee-based asset spending their foreign exchange. So that is the most important factor, not only for the real estate sector, for the stock market. Anybody who is bringing dollars and getting rupee-based assets. But the other factor is that we have not kept up with the other countries in the region, like Malaysia, Bangladesh, and other countries where they are giving some form of resident visa for the Dubai, and all these countries are giving some form of visa, Myanmar, now Vietnam, and which gives the buyer another security to have a home away from home. Like once Malaysia had a second home status, even many Sri Lankans got it, and it was hugely popular, you know, because people like to have a second option. So we have been lobbying with the government, and it is, my fingers crossed, because now the government has promised us it will come in this year's budget. Before the budget, the legal transfer will gazette the second home program. But even that, I'm a little unhappy that the threshold is $500,000. I think $250,000 will be a good value, because $500,000 is a little high, and we have to compete with Dubai and all, that's difficult. But $250,000 should be the threshold, in my opinion.
Okay. And what's the future plan and vision of the Access Group in terms of real estate and the broader kind of, you know, the other groups you are involved in? What are your future plans?
We will stick to our core business. We are a family-owned group of companies. So we were the founders, myself and my partners. Now we are about 30 to 35 years old. The second generation and the new younger people have to build on their dreams. They cannot try to live our dream, because our dream is our dream. You know what we remain is, and of course, the millennials, their aspirations, their focus and their priorities are different, and the world is also changing, you know. So now, for example, I am personally fascinated to see how the real estate factor in the shopping complex and all will develop globally, because today the younger generation is all buying offline, you know. So how it will develop, but sometimes it surprised me. One time I thought photocopies will be a thing of the past, but photocopies are yet surviving, because people want to touch and feel, people want to make presentations, this and that. So market has improved over the last 20 years, even though there are a lot of other forms of duplicating, you know.
Yeah. And what would you think of this event and similar things like this? Does it help the property market in your view?
This type of events are very good, but unfortunately, I feel that the state should also play an important role in developing events like this, helping people like you in different forms, because this is not only your developing a sector, you're carrying out a message to the community and to the world that we have things to offer, and these type of events create a better image for the country also. So I think more state involvement, like for example in Singapore and all, when they were developing, they did a meeting, MICE market, what we call MICE market, and they give huge subsidy for those type of events, which now they are reaping the benefits. So I hope the government will help enterprising people like your company to take this to another level. And I wish your organization all the best in your future endeavors.
Thank you. We also hope that the government will help not just us, but the property buying public as well, in terms of good policies for investors and the buyers. And finally, what's your advice for the buyers? It's a good time to buy at the moment?
Buying a property is a very personal in nature, and it depends on your position. You know, I believe that you must buy, if you have money you can buy, or you must buy as long as you can service the entry. Stocks and properties and all should not be bought with the idea of being free cash flow. It might be free cash flow, property might appreciate, stocks might appreciate, but you must buy what you can hold for 10 years. You know? Otherwise, you will have to take a lifestyle change to pay for your loans. So my advice is, it's a personal decision, it's a super asset. And it's an asset that Sri Lankans, being an island nation, have seen appreciation since independence or before. All properties have, generally you can say, have appreciated over the last 50, 60 years. And it becomes unaffordable for the next generation, because capital has appreciated so much. So it's a very safe investment in Sri Lanka, but as long as you don't leverage too much.
Okay, Mr. Sumal Perera, thank you very much for coming for this quick chat, even though it was on short notice, and enlightening this audience here on your thoughts and your vision about the property market and your kind of future ideas on where the market is heading. Thank you very much for your participation and for at this event and at this in this chat. And thank you, and wish you the best of luck. Thank you.
Thank you.